Welcome, welcome. This ought to be very interesting because I've started this game 3 times and I never get very far in. Super interested in the whole game, but I don't know, I just I can't even explain it. Like, in the second or third play session, something will come up. I'll be getting ready to play it in the evening, and then dinner takes too long, or I want to watch the show with my girl, or just something else. And then a day or two goes by, and I forget it. I forget the whole game. And next thing I know, it's 18 months later. That's happened like 3 times so far with this game. So I want to see this in Vorpax. The first thing I can tell you is that Jupiter, right there are waves moving across the clouds that I never noticed before until I put on the headset. The whole surface of the planet has gigantic waves. And I mean, of course it does. It's clouds, right? Just a big gas giant. I never noticed it in the pancake version. Let's see here. Let's see if I can point one out for you. Right there. Right there. And they are not regular moving across the surface. Right there. So, Edge Peak is one trick that I'll be using here. It's still rendered with 3 dimensions in this view, but it gives you a more of a fixed position so that you can see down to the corners. I want to play the whole thing zoomed in as much as I can. But I did run into some problems with that last time. Field of view. So I thought 47. I don't know what that means. So it sounded like Vorpax recommends you change the field of view somehow. But I'm gonna have to wait until I get into the game to see how. Was that centered? Did I get my configuration slightly wrong? I have to turn my head a little bit to the left to actually have the screen in my actual field of view. But let's see here. Okay, play game. Alien Isolation. Start game. Let's go. Medium. I really want to go with a higher difficulty, but I also want to see the end of the game, and I don't think I can handle the frustration right now. It right there. Okay.
Final report of the commercial starship Nostromo. Third officer reporting. The other members of the crew. Kane. Lambert. Parker. Brett. Ash. And Captain Dallas. Are dead. Cargo and ship destroyed. I should reach the frontier in about 6 weeks. With a little luck, the network will pick me up. This is Ripley. Last survivor of the Nostromo. Signing off.
I'm Samuels. I work for the company. It's about your mother.
We think we may have found her, Amanda.
A commercial vessel, the Anisadora, has recovered what we believe to be the flight recording unit of the Nostromo.
Where?
Zeta Reticulum.
What did it tell you?
We don't know. The unit was taken to Sevastopol Station. It's proprietorial material, so the company wants it to be collected as soon as possible.
I think this is all pre-rendered, because it's all two-dimensional. field of view. Definitely not right. It's a little better. Maybe a little bit too wide. Ooh, 1900 by 1200. That is not how I had it set. I'll live with it. For now, it's fine. Well, I almost had it. Yeah, that's it right there. Oh yeah, it's exactly right, right there. That's so it used to be, last time that I tried this, the shadows were only rendering in one of the eyes. That has been fixed. So, this is running as high as my computer can handle it. Well, it's running at the recommended specs for being able to launch this game in Vorpex. I still would like to tweak some of the video settings. The resolution is lower than I would prefer, and I bet I can get super sampling up a lot more here too. But yeah, this is incredible. Okay. Oh, is that all, really? I can just turn it off and on? Now that I'm dressed, no. I don't need to Is this what's beeping still? I already saved once. Yeah, it looks like that just always beeps. Okay. Oh, nice.
Oh, Samuels, did you wake up early?
Well, I don't really need this procedure as the best. I was just inspecting the Tallis facilities. A well-maintained machine. I realize it's a very similar model to
Finestrella.
Yes, Emplos. A later pattern, close inspection.
I've worked engineering jobs on ships like this.
Of course. It's Taylor. She's not a seasoned traveler. Hypersleep may have been part of it.
Haven't seen her. I'll go check on her.
Oh. Interesting. Oh, thank you for letting me know. I didn't even realize it. I can't look down at chat unless... Okay, no, I'm wrong. I can look down at chat in either view. Floats based on your head movement. Do you mean this one? Or this one? If it's the second view that always has a black box, that's just a byproduct of the distance from the screen. The virtual distance from the rendered screen. Because technically, this is the same thing. I'm just using edge peak. And then when I hit the middle button, it zooms me in closer to the window and locks it to my view. And again, I can probably do some fiddling to get that fixed, but I was more concerned about just getting the thing running tonight. But you say audio is low? I think that's how I had it on previous streams. I appreciate you giving me the info. Let me know if that's better. Speak again. Speak some more. Damn. Whoa. Oh boy. That got a flinch out of me.
Taylor, good morning. Ripley, it's certainly not good. I very much doubt it's morning either. Sorry. I feel like death. I don't know how you people put up with hypersleep regularly.
You get used to it.
I don't do long haul very often. Most legal execs don't travel further than the coffee machine.
I'm surprised Weyland-Yutani felt the need to send legal at all.
The loss of the Nostromo and its cargo cost the company a lot of money. It's important we find out what happened.
Oh, is that a hint? Ace Jack 9?
I'm sorry. That was insensitive. Realize your mother has been missing for 15 years and you...
It's okay. We'll both get what we want,
right? Still
local,
I can hear it. Thank you.
Have you seen Samuels? He's probably been up for hours.
Looks like we're up.
Oh. I actually have to hit Q to get out of it. Cool. I love these terminals. Depth of field is a little bit off. I think that's related to the... Yeah, I'm gonna have to do some more tweaks, but I'd love to get some progression here tonight first. Because this is still workable.
Hope you all had a restful journey.
The Torrens is in very good order for an old M-class captain.
She was a wreck when I bought her. Took a few years and a lot of contracts to refit. She pays for herself now.
You said we're approaching Sevastopol Station. Are we docking?
I believe your contact is Marshall Waits, is that right? I'll hail Sevastopol and arrange boarding with him.
Good. Let's get this done.
Don't worry, Miss Taylor. Routine. In and out. Connor, how are we doing?
SMG loaded and calibrated. Approach vector locked.
Prep comms so I can say hello.
Channel open, Captain.
Does everyone have their briefing document?
You can watch the approach on the monitors.
Can we see it?
Switch to monitors. Sevastopol Station.
Is that damage?
It looks like damage.
Punch up 74, tight angle.
Looks like the dry dock bay is screwed.
I can't bring the Torrens into that.
This is the commercial vessel Torrens out of St. Clair, registration number MSV7760, calling Sevastopol Traffic Control. We're carrying three passengers on a Weyland.
Yutani Bond, you're holding the Nostromo Flight Recorder Unit. We request immediate permission to transfer the passengers portside over.
Honestly, it's impressive that they can see anything at all with those monitors.
Hello, Marshall?
I wouldn't be confident giving any kind of damage report with... God, the sound... The sound design of this game, though?
Seem pretty screwed up. So I fitted Samuel's suit with a radio booster.
Absolutely amazing.
I can only keep the Torrens in transit for 24 hours.
You'll have heard from us by then.
Safe trip.
Stand by. My contract doesn't cover bloody spacewalks. It's the only option, and it's perfectly safe if you do what I tell you. Just shadow me, Taylor. You too, Samuels.
Affirmative.
My God, Ripley. You're doing good, Tim. Just keep moving!
Taylor Ripley, hold on!
Oh man, it's surreal having a helmet on now. Oh man, that was awesome. Having some dirt on the visor that I'm looking through. Whew. Okay. So that one works, and that one does not. Registration points to mainly see your progress and warn you if enemies are nearby. God, I got chills from that, man. And nothing's happening. I'm not gonna dig through every nook and cranny this time. I swear I'm gonna just make progression. Oh, this one is not as bad as the vent from Vertigo earlier. I take it back. Yeah, I don't think I've made it more than an hour in though, Eben. and it would probably took me 3 to do it. Just for reference, I mean, this is probably twice as fast as I've ever gotten to this point in the game. I just loved looking around and like reading everything. Father Corrupted. That was coming. It was more along the lines of oh yeah, that's right, quick select menu. Still going head over heels makes you kind of sick.
This'll help.
Cue to open radio, mouse to select. R to activate, gotcha. I just heard somebody above me. I had to leave the flare down there?
Hello?
Paris, Turner, get back here now. We have a track. Somewhere in engineering. Lock the terminal down. Kill the power, and don't forget your reports. Make them thorough. We're gonna need our paperwork to be bulletproof when this shit is over. Lights out. Moved our stash. Code is 0340. Pinned it in one of the storerooms. Our meds and low on water, so you're gonna need to get some. It's your turn. Maybe it'll teach you to take care of our stuff in the future. Okay, so they're heading that way from over there. Maybe I should just follow them. Can't even go this way. They must have just been in this room right here. From the terminal. Oh yeah, this one I kind of figured security checkpoint, but I just wanted to see if they were leading me somewhere. Oh. Jump the turnstile. Yeah, they want me to have to sneak under this cable, right? Or through here? Can't go through here. Together equals no future.
What the hell happened here?
The glass up there is a nice touch. Door locked. Ion torch required. I can't really tell. Did that come from right there? Ah, it must have. Look, there it is. Huh. Red lights on that door. Wait, really? I can't walk on... I can't walk on that. Hmm. Oh, I see. They want me to go upstairs. Shutters are closing. Yep, and you didn't close them. Well, I assume that there's somebody else in the ship, though. Those lights behind you are the map updates. I'm sorry, I missed when you said lights behind me are the map updates. I didn't catch when that was. It's just a light spinning around. God, the difference in looking into the light and looking into the dark, how your eyes take a moment to adjust. Really, really good attention to detail. Ejecting is not the most judicious choice of words on a space station. So, sorry, but I don't need you to come in next week. As you know, the store's been in trouble for some time now, and I couldn't get a hold of the creditors any longer. Sevastopol is finished. Time to move on. To All Space Lloyd employees. Colonial Marshals are investigating problems on station and will update accordingly. Okay. Apollo is a central AI that monitors and provides guidance for all the working Joes on Sevastopol. Apollo oversees all communications on the station, so wherever you are, you know you're in safe hands. Well, that's good to know. I'm in good hands with the friendly AI that runs the working Joes. That's no spoiler for me. I've seen them before, so. Alright. Quick break here. I'm gonna send you a message on Steam here, Evan. I can already feel the hair on my arm standing up. I did just tweak the volume up just a touch for the in-game and voice volume. I doubt it made that big of a difference, but if it's terrible, let me know. Cool, thanks. Alright. I mean, oh! Yeah, that was it. Yep, I knew there was something else down here. Oh god, I need a freaking flare, man. I don't have any. Look for live wires. Keep your eyes open for live wires. Because now that the power's turned back on.
This whole damn place is falling apart.
I could actually fry myself. Thank you, robot. Is there anything to collect? No. Ah. Yeah, see, I need the resolution up a little bit more because I'm having trouble making out what's the furthest back there. All I can see is a mess. Maybe it helps though. Oh, that's creepy. Sounds like hail. No, thank you. I know you're always conscientious. I mean, I'm sure I've said this before. I don't care a whole lot about spoilers. I don't care a whole lot about spoilers, but if you're looking to enjoy somebody's honest first reaction, then yeah, you know what to do. Hmm. so there's a door. That one's locked. Whoa, I just noticed. Oh, geez.
That's got to be the exit up ahead.
Get through the main door. Right. I mean, the biggest downside right now, though, is I want to get some more progression in, so I'm not searching every nook and cranny into the back of every corner. But, I feel like this is a normal amount of exploration for just a normie at the game. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm just skipping, but feel all right about it so far. What the fuck was that? Restore power. It's gonna tell me I need some kind of a tool here, right? Maintenance jack required. So I gotta go through that door. Yeah, the lighting is really incredible because I can't see almost anything on that side of the room because of those lights and the glare. It's great. Volumetric fog and yeah. Whoa. I knew it was an automatic door. I knew it was an automatic door. Oh. Kitty? God. Oh no. Okay. I'm really not wanting to go and turn on the power right now. I don't know why. I can't see shit. I I wish I would have picked up a pipe or something along the way. I mean, not feeling great about my choices so far. Oh, I gotta go back out into the courtyard. That's why they open these side doors. Oh, that's awful. Oh. Oh, thank God. Save point. Oh, that's not good. Spoilers, game. I mean, if you don't know, you're playing a survival horror at this point, though. Come on. The details of all this is just amazing. The texture of those chess pieces, man. The shine on those beer cans, like, I'm such a geek. Can you believe we get to live in a world where we're on board basically the Nostromo? Experiencing this in VR. I mean, seriously. Go save your game. Go save your game. Oh, that's creepy as fuck. Look at that working Joe right there. Jesus. Oh boy. This room didn't work out so well for Waits lied to us. But there's nothing in here, actually. That's cool. Oh, nice. Okay.
Oh, fuck.
That's what I'm looking for, though. I don't like that. I don't like this kind of automatic hatch. Climb. Okay. Oh God, all the flashing. Oh, the blood trail. Okay. Pretty good interaction to hold left and right mouse button and then press A. I hear you, music. What are you doing? Wait, what did I miss? The music just did a stinger, but I didn't see anything. Oh, is it that this door is open? It must be that this door is open. Somebody just came in here real quick before I got a chance to, right? Supposed to be the communication room, right? is this some kind of security office? It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Not useful, whatever it was supposed to be. Okay. So now the power's on. And I have a jack so I can just go in there.
No ships here.
There are now.
Well, that's good news, because things are not so good here. Something blew just now, rocked this whole place.
I saw it.
But lady, that's the least of our problems.
Yeah?
Yeah. Something's on this station. Something you wouldn't believe.
Like what?
A killer. You get it?
Okay. Okay. What's your name?
Axel.
I was boarding with two colleagues. EVA. We got separated by the blast. Can you help me find them?
Why?
Because you seem to know your way around.
No, I mean, why? What's in it for me?
A place on the ship.
Trust you.
I need to find comms. I need to contact my ship.
This is your lucky day. Let's go, sweetheart. Seeks and comms is in the Systex Spire. It's quite a distance, but we can get to a transit through the freight area. But watch yourself. We can get into all sorts of trouble there, okay? I don't want to stick around here long.
You know, actually, I already feel better just having you there, Axel.
Is that you following me back there?
I had to keep my distance. Can't take any chances. Stick close to me.
What?
Hey, don't move.
Okay. We're not looking for trouble. Who are you?
I'm John. This is Ringo. They're just some assholes. We haven't got time for this. Come on, Jenna.
We're trying to get to comms. Can you help us?
We don't need their help. Don't tell them anything. Look, I've got the elevator working. Jenna, let's go, okay?
I'm sorry. Good luck.
Immigration office.
Why are you so damn aggressive?
Everyone's running shit scared. Keeping to their own. Safer that way.
Okay. I guess I'll just expect to see them in like an hour and a half.
This ship of yours is
dead at the bottom of an elevator shaft.
Hold up. Let me get the elevator. Allow me. Place is old. Needs a special touch. Well, what are you waiting for? Hit the button.
I'd appreciate it if you told me what the hell was going on. Right now.
Listen, darling. When we get to the ship, we can kick back, read each other's hair, and chat all you want.
Oh, yeah?
When we get to my ship, I need to know what's going on. Right fucking now!
Fine. Like I said, there's a killer.
A killer? What does that even mean?
I ain't seen it, but it's here. Picking us off one by one.
What are you saying?
The animation's really good.
No, something else. A monster.
What? Thought you were leading.
Shit. We need to move. This way. Get down.
This is bullshit, man. You should be looking for a way off. Are you crazy? There's no way off. At least we're safe down here. For how long? What if they come for us?
Then we shoot the crap out of them.
Now shut up. You're making me nervous.
Trouble. We'll have to go random. Follow me.
Friends of yours?
I've had run-ins with those guys before. They don't like strangers. Even nice guys like me.
Grab the gun. Grab the gun. Grab the gun. Grab the gun.
To go and say hello, it's your funeral. Those guns aren't for show.
Someone should be doing something.
They are. It's called surviving.
Grab the gun, 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 grab it, grab it, grab, 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 grab the gun, grab it, grab this gun right now, grab it. Grab the gun, grab it, grab that gun.
You've been living here?
What can I say? My butler's on holiday. Grab what you need. I don't know when you'll get another chance. Been hunkered down here for a week now, waiting for a ship. Waiting for you, I guess. It can get pretty dark around here. You should take that flashlight over there. Make sure you're stocked up on batteries. Be careful not to flash it around. We don't want to get caught. Let's go.
Before I move on, so... I think this is a good time to call it for now. Tomorrow I'm planning on a long game session, and I'd much rather have the resolution issue fixed and take a look at the volume again. So, glad we were able to get this to work a bit. I have the headset off now. I'm just holding it in a relative location. And I see what you mean, Eben, that there's a black box around the screen. Unavoidable unless I use the Vorpex interface to get the there's a way to get the screen and tracking. 3D reconstruction, head tracking sensitivity, direct mode. Where is it? Oh, this is in full VR mode? I'm usually in immersive mode, and that's when you can change the screen distance. So I wonder if that makes a big difference here. Yeah, I can get the screen a lot closer to my face like this, immersive mode, but if I go out towards the edges, you do see a lot more of the background beyond the 3D rendered screen. But when I'm like this with the headset centered, I cannot see any edges right now. I see only the game world rendered in 3D. This is how I tend to play the games in Vorpex. If it can handle immersive mode, then this is how I'll do it. I am seeing a little bit of distortion in this view, so I'd probably have to change the field of view again based on this being a wider rendering in the Vorpex. I could probably push it up to 75 here. But typically this menu here, which is all of the Vorpex settings, will have the defaults that are set by the profile of the Vorpex software, and it almost always works good, but depending on your game and your tolerance, you can change a lot of what you're seeing here. Like, this will change how quickly the headset is moving, the scale at which the movement is being rendered into the game world. A 3D strength is going to be the depth of field that's being rendered by the software. Geometry is usually pretty good, with Z normal and Z adaptive being rendering saving measures. So I tend to keep it on geometry. And then there's a few different modes that you can have for the playstyle. Cinema mode is literally just an apartment with the screen in front of you. Full VR mode is some kind of a background area. I think it's color adaptive, but it doesn't give you the same level of controls, because look, image zoom instead of screen distance, which is what I got with the immersive screen mode. Immersive screen mode tends to have like a wider field of view, but not so high vertically. Yeah, so the settings of this are very good. And I mean, it's just so many versatile options. All right, well, we can talk more about that outside of the stream. I appreciate you watching. If anybody else ends up catching this, thank you for joining me. We will be back again tomorrow with more. I may start an early stream. I haven't decided. Maybe around 10 a.m. or 1 p.m. But, yeah. Keep an eye out for it. And thank you once again. Have a good night.